Hello everybody! In this video I'm going to process X-ray films for their silver content. I'm going to show you a scalable process to effectively recover silver from old X-ray films. Beforehand, I'm going to show you some tips not to waste your time on certain type of films. This is a simple test you can do to distinguish between silver containing and non-silver containing films. Those films with no silver content would turn black when exposed to the flame. And here you can see the result of dipping two different films in a lye solution. One has been washed properly while the other one just changed color. Anyway, I'm going to use lye solution to wash out silver from the films. First of all, I added about 10 liters of water to the top to make it hot. And I turned the heating element on. I placed a water pump in the top to mix water properly. Then I added 500 grams of sodium hydroxide to the water. I prepared a very dilute sulfuric acid solution to wash the films after alkaline treatment. From 13 kilograms of films, only 2 kilograms contained silver. I disposed of the remaining 11 kilograms of films as plastic waste. I started cutting the films into the smaller pieces using a blade. Then I dipped the films into the hot lye solution. You really need to be careful while working with hot sodium hydroxide solution. I let the films sit in the solution overnight. Next day, I prepared my setup to wash the remaining materials of the films. After finishing washing all the films, I rinse the lid with water and let the washed material settle for a few hours. After siphoning the solution, I transfer it to a smaller container. The suspension is mostly silver oxide suspended in the lye solution. To recover silver from this crude silver oxide suspension, I'm going to dissolve the silver oxide in a solution and recover pure silver through the electrowinning process. You can either use ammonia and sodium thiosulfate mix or cyanide to dissolve silver oxide. Then you can reclaim your silver just by using a computer power supply to do the electrolysis. Alternatively, you can filter the silver oxide and melt it in a graphite crucible to obtain the silver. 12 grams of sodium cyanide dissolve in an alkaline solution and add it to the silver oxide batch. Sodium cyanide is very toxic, so you need to be careful when handling it and never add it to an acidic solution. ml of 30% hydrogen peroxide added to accelerate the process. Now I'm going to do the electrowinning process. I cover the edges of a stainless steel sheet with a tape to prevent the growth of silver crystal at the edges. I use the steel sheet as the cathode and graphite rod as the anode. Due to the foaming, I transferred everything to a larger vessel. Silver crystals started to grow on the cathode, but they kept falling into the solution. So I came up with the idea of using steel wool as the cathode to hold the silver in place, and I used the solid stainless steel sheet as the anode. This process took me about 24 hours, and I used a few fresh steel wool to make sure there is no more silver left in the solution. To reclaim silver and dissolve iron from steel wool, I added dilute hydrochloric acid to the beaker and I started heating the solution. At the meantime, to eliminate cyanide from the waste solution, I added some bleach to the solution and let it sit for a few hours. The solution was poured off and the silver was rinsed with water a few times. That's really nice silver recovered from the mud. I placed the silver on the hot plate to dry it. After checking the bucket, I found the silver powder was dropping up from the stainless steel cathode. There we go. Here are the silver covered.
through the electrowinning cell. This one recovered using steel wool as the cathode, and it seems more pure than this one being recovered using the solid cathode, stainless steel cathode, which has fallen at the bottom of the cell, and I washed and cleaned it and accumulated at the bottom. I'm going to melt them together to a bead and weigh it afterwards.